first commercial break, and here goes the two big boys. Fraser McLaren, Brian McGrattan. Expected truculence. McGrattan with now 55 penalty minutes in his career against the Leafs.
And it looks like Bortolo, McGrattan's second tilt of this season. These are the super heavyweights right here. Bortolo landing some rights. Now McGrattan, they're just tossing them.
Oh, there's some heavy bombs. Oh, now McGrattan's got it going. He, I mean, you see a guy like McGrattan, he just stands there. Then you see that right hammer just start to fly.
Gloves are off. McGrattan drops the mitt with Luke Gazdik. No punches yet. McGrattan lands a right. Gazdik's helmet off. The gamer.
Boy, is he ever.
He's taking a few over the top, and he's staying in there.
Wow.
And while this is going on, Beloff is down on all fours at center ice. Grattan lands a couple more. Gastick still throwing.
Both teams up on the bench, too. Rooting for their teammate. This is a long one.
12-rounder. Well, hopefully McGrattan catches his breath by the time he has to come on with you and Scott on After Hours.
Well, we have lots to talk about, don't we? Had a great scoring chance. We had a fight.
Yes, we've got a fight now. Brian McGrattan and Chris Bartsch. McGrattan with four fights on the season. Bartsch with a pair. Brian McGrattan unloading with some rights. Bartsch trying to get his right free. And he's gets a good one in on McGrattan, but McGrattan continues to hammer away. Now he's using the left and the right. And Brian McGrattan going right after Bartsch. These are going to leave some marks on these big boys.
Well, there's a headache coming after this one, too. As you can see the defensive position right there by Bartsch.
Brian McGrattan, I would say the aggressor and the winner of that.
Here's McGrattan dropping out with Brandon Bullock, so the big boys are going to go to work here late in the first period. Fourth fight of the season for Brian McGrattan, and off to a big start. Bullock, a St. Louis, Missouri native, but the guy from Hamilton's doing the most damage here.
He got his arm out of his jersey in a hurry, and not much for Bullock to hold on to at this point. Trying to stay in tight because McGrattan's got that right arm free.
Well, Bullock hanging in though.
Now we got a fight. The kid wants it. The kid's going to get it. Brian McGrattan and Dylan McElrath. McElrath, the penalty minute leader in the American Hockey League. And Brian McGrattan trying to get those rights free. This one comes in front of the Rangers box, and McGrattan, again, very patient, but this young man is game.
Well, he's big too, 6'5", 230. They're about the same size. McGrattan gets that helmet off, and here come the rabbit punches. He's known for that. He is not afraid to keep throwing those at that point. Gets the advantage, two or three, and they've got to hurt. I tell you what, they've got to hurt off the side of the head.
Oh, some bombs now by McGrattan.
Oh,
he just straightened him up. And it looks like the linesmen are going to jump in here in a second, and they do.
A little bit of a nod again. It's always the end of the fight. Good job, kid.
England and McGrattan.
There you go.
He accepted the tap, and he just got hit hard, and England went down in a hurry. The Edmonton native got it right on the chin from McGrattan, and now McGrattan has backed off, and the linesmen have come in.
No animosity there, a little tap on the head, and I just think England didn't expect that quick little jab.
Anthony Peluso and Brian McGrattan. As McGrattan trying to load up those rights he's become famous for.
Well, he sets it up with the short left jabs, and then he gets the head turned at that point, and then come the big bombs at that point. Peluso standing right in there.
The 24-year-old from North York going up against one of the league's toughest in Brian McGrattan, who ends it right there. McGrattan's ninth fight of the year, Peluso's fifth.
Puck gets thrown in and just a little bit redirect. Peluso's talking all the way up. He's backing up. He says, you want to go? You want to go?
BX is going to face off against Westgaard, so the defenseman moves up for the Canucks.
Tortorella at the Vancouver bench is already looking at the
Calgary
bench.
And here we go.
Bench.
Line brawl to start this game. Westgaard and BX are separated. Sestito and McGrattan back at the blue line. Torts is angry.
Is he ever? He's looking directly at the Calgary Flames bench.
So we got two fights going on. Kevin BX is now with Schmid on the near boards, and it's Westgaard and Lane near the Vancouver blue line. Will Sestito and McGrattan go at it near the Calgary blue line? Welcome to the NHL, Kellen Lane.
Handling himself really well, too, considering his opponent.
Lane is 6'6".
McGrattan just got the best of Sestito.
Meantime, back in the Vancouver end, in front of Roberto Luongo, Weiss and Jones are separated, and looks like cooler heads are about to prevail. But, Kelly, we saw this coming when we got the starting lineups tonight.
No question about it. When you get these kind of guys and you know the rivalry between the two teams, this clearly makes a lot of sense from what we saw with the starting lineups.
So you see Tortorella
still going at it.
And the visiting team submits their lineup and their starting five before the home team does. So Tortorella still yelling at Bob Hartley, who's not even coming over to engage in the conversation.
Kessler and Hudler.
And now Hartley comes over as some of the Flames have gone towards the photographer's moat between the benches. The Canucks are over there. Burrows in his first game back with the
Shane
protector
O'Brien,
around his broken jaw.
That's normally at the other end of the bench, made his way down by the forwards on the Flames.
John Tortorella has gone over to the Calgary Flames hallway outside their room. That's the Canucks coach outside the Calgary room. There's Brian McGrattan trying to push him aside with some of the Calgary staff.
Okay, he's got to calm down.
Yep. Shane O'Brien in the doorway with his gear off. This is outside the Calgary Flames dressing room.
There goes Clint Malarchuk, the goalie coach for the Flames.
Burrows came over to help out his coach as well. And this is not over yet, Kelly. Again, this all started with the opening faceoff of this game when Calgary started their fourth line and the Canucks responded with theirs, and we had a full line brawl.
There's Glenn Gullickson. You can't see him now. He was in the screen, the assistant coach for Vancouver, trying to get John Tortorella out of there.
It's just off camera now, as you mentioned, and it looks like finally cooler heads have prevailed. Well, we have had everything.
And here we have a first battle, and we knew this was going to come sooner or later.
Brian Allen trying to change things, deciding to go with McGrattan. 11th fight of the year for Brian McGrattan. This is the fifth fight for Allen. McGrattan trying to load up those rights. McGrattan just timing them. This is what he does for a profession. Look at that. Now Allen fighting back, and McGrattan got the best of him. And there it is.
Good work by the Flames' fourth line.
Throwing their weight around, caused a turnover. Finishing his check here, Clayton Stoner. Boy, that's a lot of power as those boards rock all the way up and down that left-hand side.
Here's Andrew Shaw, look out, McGrattan at him in his sights.
He didn't pick him up until the last second. Brian McGrattan laid up a little bit, but not on Keith.
They got all of Duncan Keith.
Ryan, big earned McGrattan, big old run at Riley Nash in that first period. And this is momentum building in the first period.
Batted in, Westgaard pounding on the forecheck. Here comes McGrattan, and he runs Prosser down.
Brian McGrattan knows what his job is. As we went to commercial break, this continued on. We saw Ribeiro going at McGrattan. Then Ribeiro got into it with Glenn Cross as well. So,
but Ramo just continues to make big saves, and there's the big hit I'm talking about.
We didn't have flats from him. I mean, he just gave it to you. My kids probably used it to shoot in the backyard.
Ron Erskine on Ben Street, the loose puck is from the score! Lance Boma taps it home.
They're really in no danger as he gets the puck around the back of the net, except McGrattan's there to get to the puck first, and when Neubert whiffs it behind the net, it's a freebie for Lance Boma.
It's an in front, and Paul Byron couldn't get much on it. It's Boma to McGrattan, shoots, scores! First goal in 30 games, Brian McGrattan makes it 1-0.
Goes into an offensive position. So Boma starts things up, big hit down low, and there's that quick pass to Brian McGrattan. Right there as the play is made, and then he wins the battle for that loose puck as McGrattan pulls out of a defensive position, back into the offense, quick snapshot.
I think he did. Matt scrambled there, but he is smart enough to just spread out.
Long shot in by McGrattan, who scores from center ice. Brian McGrattan outside the blue line, fools Eddie Lack, who smacks the back of the net out of frustration, and the Calgary Flames taking a 1-0 lead.
Well, every goaltender at some point will let in a goal like this, and it skips a little bit, but I'm unsure how Lack could miss that one.
Brian McGrattan just over center ice when he took that shot, gets his second goal of the season.
And that goes wide. Reinhardt turns, goes to the point. Butler shoots, McGrattan turns, fires, score!
Good move by Reinhardt, who got in very quickly on the backhand. Nothing develops. Back to the point. It stopped in front right there. But instead of just giving the puck away, McGrattan protects the puck with his body. Turns, spins, and lets go a bomb. And it just beats Jones on the glove side above the pad.
And what a good hold the line for Calgary. Lee Sharp tipped it from the back.
Decent shape defensively here, but this is excellent work to keep the puck alive. Maroon can't get to the puck. Smead gets to it, and he shoots it. It bounces off of Westgarth and then off of Brian McGrattan, and Big Earn is tied the score at 1.
That's 3 goals in the month of March for McGrattan, right? For a guy who never scored more than 3 goals in a season.